What's up, guys? It's Tom. Welcome back to the lab. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to my life. Today, I have a hands-on application how-to video for you. I've recently been covering a lot about link click campaigns versus conversion campaigns and how to drive traffic from Facebook, Instagram, and Messenger to your Spotify profile and get new listeners for your music. So today, what I want to do is a very simple, very direct video about how to set up a conversion campaign in Facebook Ad Manager so that you can optimize finding your audience and get more people to your Spotify profile. Now, before we dig in, I want to remind you, as always, to please subscribe to the channel. Like this video if you're feeling it and share it with your friends if you really, really find value in it. I would appreciate it. They would appreciate it, and you end up coming out looking like the good guy, so everybody wins. Moving on. What we're gonna do is dig into Facebook Ad Manager. I'm gonna show you exactly how to create a new campaign and optimize it for conversions so that you can get more followers and more listeners on Spotify. Now, if you haven't watched any of my videos before and you want to know how to set up a conversion event, check out this video here and then come back to the current video. I'm not gonna go into the complete details in this video for how to set up your conversion events, but in that video, I cover how to set up multiple event types from a standard event to a custom conversion event. And I even walk through some issues that could arise, some common things that might come up that make your conversion events not work and how to troubleshoot them. So it's a good video, check it out. It will be really, really helpful for you before you dig into setting up your campaign in this video. So let's dig into it. All right, we're here in Facebook Ad Manager. And the first thing I wanna do is go to the Events Manager, which is where we have our conversion events all set up. And I just wanna give you a brief walkthrough of what I have in here so that you know what I'm referencing when we're setting up our campaign. So under the standard events, we have page view and view content events. I use custom conversions for my campaigns. I like them better. I find it's more usable data on the other side of it, and it helps me with my retargeting efforts in a bigger way later on. So I've got a few different custom conversions here. Streaming conversion, Spotify conversion, Must Be Dreaming landing conversion, and Apple Music conversion. Now, if you want to know kind of what all these apply to, this is what we're doing. I'm driving traffic from my ad to a landing page. This landing page for my current song, Must Be Dreaming, which if you want to check that out, there's a link in the description of this video above the fold. You can go listen to that song on your platform of choice. What I do is I show the ad, the link in that ad links to this landing page, and this gives the user an option to go to Spotify or Apple Music. I keep it simple because data has shown that the more options you have on a landing page, the lower your conversion rate is, which is very interesting. So more choices equals decision fatigue equals less people converting through. So you want to keep your landing page very simple. So on my landing page, I have these two buttons, a button to go to Spotify and a button to go to Apple Music. Here's how it relates to my custom conversions. Must Be Dreaming landing conversion is the address for this landing page. This fires when someone goes to this landing page. The Spotify conversion is someone who clicks this button, the play button, to go to Spotify. And then the Apple Music conversion is someone who clicks this button to go to Apple Music. And then the streaming conversion is someone who clicks either the Spotify button or the Apple Music button. Doesn't matter which one, as long as they click a button on the landing page. Now, how do I do that? How do I track these button clicks without using the page view metric? Well, I used a link tracking tool called PixelMe that allows me to embed my Facebook pixel into the link that is behind those buttons so that I can fire that pixel upon the click and then track the conversion here. If you want to know more about that, check out this video here on PixelMe, and I will walk you through how that works and why I use it. Suffice it to say, it has been a very helpful tool for me. So I created my custom conversions, and now we know that they're working because of the evidence on the screen here. But what we can do is we can test this conversion event real quick. We'll go to test events here, and we will enter this website URL, copy that, go here, open website, and we'll make sure everything's firing first. That's what we like to do. We like to make sure everything is working. Oh, I have my ad blocker on. Pause on all sides. All right, open website. See, that's a thing that can happen. Watch your ad blocker. So as you can see, the standard page view event is firing and my Must Be Dreaming custom conversion is firing. So I'm just gonna click this real quick. As you can see, it goes through to Spotify. And then I'm going to click this one real quick. And that goes through to Apple Music, which is awesome. Now that we've confirmed both of those are working, you can see that they're working in the back end of Facebook's Ad Manager. So now that we know that our custom conversions are working, it's time to set up our ad campaign. So we're gonna go to the nine dots here. We're gonna go to Ads Manager, close this. And we're gonna go to Create. Now, here's where we choose the kind of campaign we want to run. In our case, we're gonna choose conversions. And the reason we're choosing conversions is because conversions require the viewer of the ad to take a specific action that we tell Facebook we want them to take. In this case, we're going to tell them that we want them to click one of the two buttons on our landing page. If they don't click one of those two buttons, Facebook does not see that as a successful conversion, which means they are not optimizing the ad to be shown to that person or a person like that. They want to optimize to show the ad to someone who is going to click the button. So by giving it this sort of 1-2 set of instructions, we're weeding out the people who aren't going to be genuinely interested in hearing our music in the first place, which gives us more bang for our buck as a marketer and advertiser on Facebook. So we're going to click, we're going to select conversions, we're going to select continue. We'll set up, we'll just keep it called new campaign, no categories, campaign objective, conversions, auction, yes, no spending limit. We're going to set a daily budget of, wow, $100, no. Daily budget of $10. Now we're gonna go next to the ad set level. And this is where most of the stuff happens. We're gonna call this test ad set. And here, the conversion event location is on our website. So we're gonna select pixel, my pixel. And here's where we choose an event. I'm going to select the streaming conversion event, which means I want someone to click one of the two buttons, it doesn't matter which one to me, on that landing page. I just want them to get to the landing page, click a button, and then go to a profile. So I'm gonna select the streaming conversion. So every time someone clicks a button on the landing page, Facebook is gonna go, ha, success, this is what we want. Let's find more people like that. And the reason this is more effective than a link click campaign is a link click campaign, Facebook gets excited when somebody just clicks the link. They don't have to go through to anywhere. All they have to do is click on the link in the ad. So by setting our link on a page that is back from the ad, we ensure that someone has to see the landing page and select an option after that. So we're weeding out bots and we're weeding out people, again, who just aren't as interested. We're gonna set this to start tomorrow at midnight, no end date. And for audience, I'm going to use my lookalike audience for North America. And we're gonna close that. So this can just be worldwide for this custom audience because in my lookalike custom audience, I've only selected the countries that I want to use in the first place. We're gonna set our ages to be more appropriate towards my demographic who likes my music, which is 18 to 34. We are not going to reach people beyond your detailed targeting selections. We're gonna select manual placements. Oh, excuse me. Here, under detailed targeting, we're gonna select people who like Spotify. If you don't have a lookalike audience, and you want to target just a specific set of locations or a set of all the Spotify territories, then this is the place where you would narrow your audience down further and pick a band that is similar to the music that you make. In this case, we'll pick Seven Lions. So I wouldn't use this in conjunction with a lookalike audience, but if I didn't have the lookalike audience, I would select, say, United States, get rid of the lookalike audience, and add Seven Lions as my narrowing down field from Spotify. So since we have the lookalike audience, I'm going to get rid of that. Placements. You want manual placements. You don't want automatic placements. So we are going to get rid of all feed placements. We're only going to keep the stories placements. Because when you are browsing through stories on your phone, no matter where it is, it's more likely that you have your sound on than when you're scrolling through a feed on Facebook or Instagram. So because we're marketing music, we want people to hear it so that they will click through. Stories placements are the way to go. And you're going to format your ad to be the proper proportions for a stories placement. Now we get down here, cost control is off. Nope. So this is all good to go in the ad set area. We're going to go next. All right, we'll call this test ad. Select my Instagram account. We'll do a single image or video. None of those checkboxes. We're going to add a video. Use a video in your stories ads. Again, you need the sound, you need the movement. A static image is not going to market your music well. So we're gonna select a video. We're gonna choose Dreaming Ad number 2, because this one has been performing pretty well for me. And then in the link, we are going to put the link to my landing page. We're going to preview it to make sure it's correct. There it is. So we've got our ad, we've got the link to our landing page, and we're good to go. Facebook pixel selected, click publish. And there we go. Our new campaign is scheduled and ready to go and ready to start converting people to our Spotify profile. Now, another quick note on these placements. You're using stories placements, and the reason you want to use all three is because Spotify's algorithm likes it when traffic comes from different places. You're going to have traffic coming from multiple countries if you've filled out all of the Spotify territories in your targeting area, and you're going to have it coming from multiple websites. Messenger, Facebook, and Instagram, according to Spotify, are all three different places. So multiple countries, multiple locations on the internet equals their algorithm getting jazzed about the amount of traffic that's coming to your song. This is how you do it. This is how you set up a conversion campaign. This is by far the best way to market your music to new listeners, to a new audience, and to get people converted to fans on your Spotify profile. I hope this helps. If you want to check out some other videos, again, you can check out this video here to learn how to set up your conversion events, and you can check out this video right here to learn how to set up PixelMe and learn more about how that can help you with this kind of thing. So I hope it helps. That's it for this video. I appreciate you being here, and I will catch you on the next one. Peace.